Today on Main Street, Bruce Springsteen tells of his troubled teens, the humiliation of strip searches in public schools, and in person, Tempest Bledsoe of The Cosby Show. Here's your host, Bryant Gumbel.
We want to take a look at Bruce Springsteen. Everybody knows that he was born in the USA. Most of you probably also know he was born in New Jersey, specifically in the borough of Freehold. Did his past offer any clues to his future? You be the judge.
Sometimes I'll be laying in bed and I'll be thinking that it's amazing. I can't believe it. You know, when I was 14 or 15, I thought about doing this. And somehow I did it.
Are you ready, people? Are you ready, Baxter? Well, you see, I had this friend, was a big baseball player back in high school. Yeah, man, he could throw that. Bar, I was walking in, he was walking out. We went back inside, sat down, had a few drinks, but all he kept talking about was glory days. There were passing by glory days.
I grew up in a little town where there was nothing coming down. Like, one side's Italian, the other side's Irish. They're pretty loose, you know. But I remember when I seen the Beatles, like, my father hated it. It was great. You know, he was like, boy, we used to fight. I used to want to watch, I think Bonanza or something was on the same time as Ed Sullivan on Sunday night. We used to battle over that TV, you know, life or death. And a lot of times, you want to erase too much of your past, you know, things where you feel either, you know, you've been hurt or you've been a little bit of the black sheep, you know, when you're a kid. When I was young, you know, I wanted to play, I wanted to perform, I wanted to travel.
We drove down from New York City. The girls are pretty, but they just want to know you're mad.
I still remember seeing him walking down the hall, carrying his books like this. And if you were cool, you didn't do that.
Like George said, he just never did anything but play music. I mean, I don't think he ever had a job, did he?
Not that I know of.
Yeah.
That's why they called him the bum.
I thought it was the boss.
He definitely didn't look the guitar player part. Or, you know, I thought maybe he would be a good science student.
You know, in school, I guess, you know, they try to get you through and get you out, you know, mainly.
He wasn't a superstar. He didn't fail everything. He didn't get straight A's. He was just an average student.
I wasn't interested in what they were teaching in school.
I'm not really sure whether he was listening to me in the front of the classroom. Maybe he was working on his lyrics way back then. Who knows?
I wasn't a stupid person. I didn't get real good marks, but I was smart, you know. I think there's a lot of people and kids like that that are smart, but they just don't fit. They don't fit in the educational system. You know, an educational system is tremendously narrow and it's tremendously limited, you know, even when it's working well, you know.
I think Bruce made it in spite of us.
You know, my education was those records, man. That's something that I couldn't teach me in school. You know, I couldn't learn it in the house. You couldn't learn it from people you're hanging with out on the street or anything. It's the only message, really, is you know, don't sell yourself short. You know.
Are
going to change the world, or but you can change something, you know. You can change people's, I think you can change people's lives with it. I always, you know, it happened to me, you know.
There's a lot of superstars out there. There's Prince, there's Hall & Oates, a lot of folks. Yet he's special. How come, Maggie?
Probably because both all people of all ages, young and old, like him. Probably.
Yeah. Honest, straightforward. During our breaks, we're going to take a look at MTV's Hot 4 Videos of the Week. When we come back, a look at strip searching in the public schools.
We'll return after these messages.
It's breakfast, all right.
I'll go squawk it.
Can nothing stop these zoggies?
Ah! Crunch Power can. It locks delicious sweet taste in.
Yikes!
So it's tough to suck out.
You got the point. Captain Crunch is a crunchy part of a balanced breakfast.
They're here. Crunch Cruisers. Fun. Flying saucers that glow.
Wow, they glow.
Crunch Cruisers. There.
Out of this world.
One landing in each specially marked box of Cap'n Crunch cereal.